also a great way to try out a specific choice before committing to a full bottle. If you're a signature scent type person, take a simple quiz on Scentbird, and based on your preferences, any previous purchases, and quiz answers, they'll help you to find the fragrance you'll love. Scentbird carries Prada, Gucci, Versace, and niche brands as well. This month I received 3. I personally let them surprise me, but usually you pick. And these were all very different. Catherine Melandrino Unconquered, I thought was perfect for work or daytime, with the mandarin orange and coconut milk. Then Hope, wonderfully floral. I would wear this on an early evening date. And finally, Monique Lhuillier. This one makes me feel expensive. I don't know if it's the Sicilian bergamot or what, but very, very nice. So be sure to use my coupon code GB for 55% off at Scentbird. That's a little over $7 for your first month. Available in the USA and Canada. You can also check out the links below. Thank you so much, Scentbird, for this sponsored Saturday. And thank you for watching. Can you hear me? Alright, good. Hi. My name's Gibi. Yes, you fainted, but don't worry. You're okay. Everything looks alright. I just got here. So I do just want to ask you a few questions. If you could do me a big favor, don't move or try to get up yet. We're in a safe place, so don't worry about that. And your friend who is with you, they just went to go get the car, okay? So they'll be back in a second. What's your name? Okay, and how old are you? Do you know your birthday? What year is that? Okay, great. Do you know what today is? Yep. Good job. Okay. So, do you remember what happened? Okay. Have you ever been stung by one of those before? Do you know if you have allergies? Do you have allergies to any other insect bite or sting? Okay. I am carrying an EpiPen on me, so what I want you to do is just pay attention if you have any trouble breathing, notify me right away. It looks like you were stung on the hand. Yeah, well, it looks pretty swollen, so you could be slightly allergic, but this would be used for anaphylaxis. But you seem like you're alright right now, but in case that does happen, you will also be okay. Alright, so can you tell me if you're taking any other medication, or are there any parts of your medical history that I should know? Okay. Okay. Do you remember the last thing you had to eat and drink? When was that? Okay. Alright, I'm just going to continue checking you over. Make sure I'm not missing anything. While I do that, can you describe your pain level for me? scale of 1 to 10? Mm-hmm. And what kind of pain is it? And where is that pain located? Okay. Okay, great. You can just breathe normally. Make sure to remember to breathe, of course. Alright, well that would make sense. Your friend said that they didn't think that you hit your head or anything when you fainted, but that it came on pretty suddenly. So it seems like what happened is that you got stung and then fainted. Are you afraid of insects? Has that ever happened to you before? Do you faint a lot? Okay. I'm going to take a look in your eyes, okay? So go ahead and just keep your eyes on my nose, alright? Good. Good. Keep looking at my nose. Good. Mm-hmm. Okay, I'm just going to lift your eyelids slightly and get a little closer. Look down for me. Good. Okay. Now if you look at my nose, how many fingers am I holding up? How about now? Okay, look at my nose. How many fingers am I holding up? How about now? Good. All right. Can you open your mouth for me? Okay, I'm just gonna take a look inside your mouth in case there's any damage done when you fell. Okay. Just, can you say, ah? Good. Now when I touch your jaw, does that hurt? Pain. Can you move your tongue out for me and then to the side? The other side. Okay. And can you clench down your teeth for me? Great. Thank you. You don't have any blurry vision? And how about up close? I'm gonna cover one of your eyes. Can you read the smallest line you can for me? That one? Okay. You can read the letters for me, or the numbers. The numbers, yeah. Great. Other eye, same thing. Can you read that same line with the numbers? Okay, now which way is the E pointing? Either left, down, up, or right? Okay, good, good, good. I'm just gonna give you a little bottle of water. It would be great if you could just drink some of this and take some sips when you can. Just little sips. You don't have to do anything too crazy, but that should help. Put that next to you, okay? Don't lose the cap. Alright. I'm also going to put this on your finger. We're going to check your blood oxygen. It just clamps on. It doesn't hurt. Go ahead and give me the finger that didn't get stung. Okay, very good. I'll take a second to get a reading. And I'm gonna get your blood pressure as well, okay? Do you know if you have a history of high or low blood pressure? Okay. Put this on your arm. and then it's going to get a little bit tight, okay? Of the swelling, I want to go ahead and take care of that, and it's minor enough that we can do it here. Again, we don't have to transport you to the emergency room. There's no major bleeding or anything, it's just a sting, and I'm guessing that the stinger is still in there, so I can get that out. That makes you nervous. Here. Would you like a lollipop? It actually might make you feel a little bit better. This one is cherry. Here you go. Okay. And then you can have that. In my bag here. Okay. Really good travel bag. Shrug your shoulders for me. Okay. And then lift up one arm. Lift up the other. Great. Alright. Good. I'm just gonna check your neck here. And no pain in your neck. How about numbness? No numbness anywhere? Like tingling? Okay. Like, can you feel that?
If you close your eyes, do you feel that? That? Good. Good. Okay. You can open your eyes. Alrighty then. I'm going to need my tweezers here. Sometimes you can use like a credit card, kind of like a stiff, whoosh, flat object like that. That works too in a pinch. But I've got these great guys. Very fine tip. That should be not painful at all. It will be very precise. Get that right out. Okay. Now for the scrape on your arm. I might want to use just a little bit of the topical solution here to kind of flush it out. You fell on dirt, so I gotta make sure there's no pebbles or anything in there. Okay. Go ahead and give me your arm. Sting a little bit. Not too bad. Good. Okay. Alright. Just going to let that dry for a moment. Get my bandages out here. Blood oxygen, perfect, thank you. Yeah, so we have the glue, essentially. That would be more for like a deep wound. I think for this, it's a very shallow scrape. I'm gonna put a gauze pad over that. This one. This one's a little too big and this one's a little too small, so we'll go with the big one. Okay, not stick to your wound too much. Just going to place that over. Is a beautiful day out. Always a shame when something like this happens, but hopefully you'll start feeling better in a minute. Okay, I think I can use the elbow bandage for this since it's kind of right on the edge there. Right, How's that lollipop? Good. And you can take this off when you get home if you want to change it. I would recommend washing with soap and water anyway. Here you go. You could put a little ointment on it if you want, especially if it starts hurting. Useful in handling the pain that you're describing. Don't feel like we need to give you medication beyond topical. Okay. So, since the swelling is kind of bad, did you want me to cut off that event wristband? Yeah. Those are annoying to get off anyway. I'm just gonna use these scissors. Don't worry, they're gonna go right under your arm. And we're gonna get that off for you, okay? There you go. Take that out. That's better. Just one stinger, looks like, right there. Pretty red, pretty swollen. Yeah, that does look like it hurts pretty bad, so don't worry. Did you get a look at what the insect looked like? Like a bee, you know? Okay. Okay, yeah. But you've not been stung by that before. Okay. Alright. Nothing worse, no nausea, itching, swelling anywhere else, shortness of breath, trouble breathing. Take a big, deep breath together. Wonderful. Okay, so I'll get the tweezers and we'll get that stinger out. What I want to do is very gently. The stinger should be quite easy to get out. I'm going to just do use a little antiseptic on it. First. Okay. a little bit closer. And I'm gonna take a look with my light here. Kind of bring your hands up for me. Okay. Perfect. Kind of just going underneath. Where we just pulled out the stinger. And then another one here. That was a nasty one. Oh no, I don't blame you for fainting. No. Not at all. So I'm going to apply a little bit of cream after the sting relief. Okay. So this should basically numb the area. And cooling as well, for sure. Okay, just like that. Good. Okay. All right. Ointment wise, could just go a little overboard today. Might as well. I'm already here. But we want to make sure. Okay. And we'll apply it. The sterile Q-tip. There you go. Don't want too much, but that should help. Get a little tiny band-aid here. Cover it all up. Of course, I already put them away. I like to keep things organized, so sometimes. Coming back to something. Right. Should have a tiny one in here. And this can just kind of wrap around the sting, go around.
Right. Now, is anything else bothering you now that that's sort of been addressed? Anything you didn't notice before? Good. I'm glad to hear that. Go ahead and start putting these things away then. Good. And you feel a little stronger now. I'm glad to hear that. Alright. Here we go. Make sure I get my bag out of here. Okay. So, obviously, taking you with me to the hospital or calling in an ambulance for you or anything. If anything changes, just call back. Obviously, we're in the area, so now that I have treated your scrapes on your arm, should be set. No signs of any other allergic reaction, just, you know, some swelling of the hand, but your hand wasn't itching either. Okay. Great. I'm just going to... Alright. Great. Absolutely, you could head home if you needed to. I think they were in a little bit of a panic after seeing you faint, so I think they'll probably want to take you home. Not a terrible idea. Just get normal rest, drink extra water, and yeah, continue to enjoy your weekend. Everything should be okay.